Test 1, 2, check 1, 2.
Thank you. Good morning. Welcome to the Florence S. Brown Pre-K Celebration. We are honored to celebrate our 50th anniversary. My name is Kathy Mikens. I am the program administrator. I come from a long line of program administrators here at Florence Brown. And it's an exciting day to be here. And I welcome all of you. I'm so excited that all of you decided to come out on this rainy day to join us in our celebration. Today, we're going to start off the celebration. We're honored to have an alumni join us. He's flown in from Washington, D.C. He is works with the Department of Defense. He will be starting his master's degree at Johns Hopkins. You already started? He is soon to be getting married in July. Did you get? Okay. Here to welcome Charles Bester Wims. Did I get that right?
Good morning.
Good morning.
Excuse me if I sound nervous. So, to Dr. Ellison, the mayor, staff, faculty, administration, friends, family, parents, students, I'm honored and excited to be back home in Rochester and at school number 33. So I left work one day and received a phone call from my former church in Alabama. And I returned the call and the secretary told me to call the principal of school number 33. I'm thinking to myself, how in the world did they know to find my church number one and to think to contact them to tell me to call the principal of 33 school? So I called Mr. Ellison and he formally invited me to speak on April 26th, which was perfect for me. Then the very next day, they changed the date to May 5th, which is the same day my fiance graduates today with her master's degree. So luckily, I was able to get a flight from Rochester to Alabama that allowed me to come here and speak this morning and be in Alabama on time for the graduation. So as it was mentioned, my name is Charles Bester Wims. I'm originally from Rochester, New York. I moved to Alabama after the sixth grade. I graduated from Alabama A&M University with a bachelor's degree in computer science. I currently live in Maryland, working as a forensic analyst. I'm also working on my master's degree at Johns Hopkins University, also in computer science. I'm also a former student here at school number 33 and in the Florence S. Brown Pre-K program. I, like many other students here, started in Miss Munir's class. I can remember the days when we would go to the little area outside and ride the little red tricycles. and when it was time to sit in our cubby holes, when it was time for our parents to come pick us up. And when we had a whole program with skits and speeches for our pre-K graduation. This was a time when our imagination ran wild in our minds. There were so many things to do, so many things to be. I went on to kindergarten and the rest of elementary school. And as I've grown to be the man that I am today, I realized that having a solid education is crucial to an individual's success. We now live in a society where in numerous fields, you need a master's degree or equivalent to be qualified for just an entry-level position. Therefore, it is important for students to stay in school. Each grade you go through lays the foundation for the next grade or step. And for this school, it starts here in the Florence S. Brown Pre-K program. Who would have thought that Pat Reese's son, who started here at school number 33, would be traveling to countries like China and Thailand? speaking on a panel with the Secretary of Education, or even going to meetings or invited to ceremonies at the White House. Those are the opportunities that I have been afforded, and it all started with my education here. My undergraduate alma mater, Alabama A&M University, has a motto, "Start here, go anywhere." This same motto is true for Florence S. Brown Preschool Program and school number 33. I'm thankful for all my teachers, principals, staff here who all embody the spirit of Miss Brown, a woman who was a hands-on person and was very personal with the faculty and students. You all have played a part in making me the man that I am today, and I'm extremely grateful. And as I close, I would like to encourage the students to always do your best, dream big, set goals, and finish strong. Education is the key to success. I remember growing up, they used to have the big poster with that same motto, education is the key to success. School is not hard. I mentor a lot of kids now, and I always tell them school is not hard. And they look at me crazy, like I'm struggling in math or whatever. I'm like, no, you're not struggling, it's how much you put into it. And the biggest factor is how much you invest in yourself. When you invest in yourself, you'll receive a great return on investment. So with that, I would like to thank you guys for inviting me, and have a great day.
Good morning.
Good morning.
I'm Robin Hooper. I'm the Early Childhood Director for the district, but at one time, I was a program administrator here for about 6 years, one of the best experiences in my life. And I remember when Charles Vester was a student here. So it's a real thrill to be able to see him as the man he is today, how he has grown, and the success that he's had. I consider myself to have been very fortunate to have come after a long line of strong leaders of this program. The Florence S. Brown Pre-Kindergarten Program was the first state-funded program here in Rochester when the state of New York Education Department started funding pre-kindergarten programs. And Florence Brown, as one of the first teachers, really gave her heart and soul to this program. She became probably the second administrator. There was someone for a very short time before her, but she was the administrator for almost 20 years, and she was very dedicated to this program. She was very hands-on. I remember hearing stories about her when the children were playing outdoors or in the water. She would get right in there with them, would participate, would come into the classrooms regularly. She regularly took trips to Albany to support the program. She would always ride the train. And for many years, that became part of the responsibility of the program administrator here, because the funding was never certain for pre-kindergarten programs. I recall when I was program administrator, back in the years 2000, 2001, the early 2000s, 2006, when we did the 40th anniversary here, I was here for that, we were still struggling to maintain our funding. Every year, the funding was proposed to be cut, and every year, a large group of parents would get together, and they would take the bus to Albany. We'd get up, and it'd be 5:30 in the morning, whole busload of parents ready to go to Albany to fight to keep this program alive. So the reason that we are standing here today, that this program is so successful and it's still here, is because of the parents and the community and a lot of the families and parents that have been instrumental in making this program a real possibility, and that it's still here today, are actually here with us. So not that I want to embarrass them, but I have to call out just a few names. Mrs. Loretta Cross has worked tirelessly over the years. I remember her gathering signatures on petitions. to keep the program going. At one point, the whole school was projected to be closed. The staff and the families got together. There were t-shirts. There were all kinds of efforts made, and it's because of the families, the community, and the staff that we are here today, and we have had a successful program here for 50 years. And I can't think of anything more outstanding, better for our community than what that says, keeping this program for 50 years. Very recently, we had the top people from the state, the coordinator of the Office of Early Learning, and one of her state representatives come through. In fact, it was only last week, and toured this program. And I am very proud to say they were very impressed. At the end of their tours, I've already gotten the report, district-wide, there were no citations or violations for any of our programs that they toured, including this one. I think that's really outstanding, and it says a lot about what progress we've made and the quality of our programs, and particularly our first program, the Forerunner, Florence S. Brown Pre-K. I remember many happy memories through the years. A lot of the things that the families, the staff, and the communities have done here to celebrate and to provide excellent opportunities for our children, whether it be raising money for field trips or to bring special activities here, especially around the holiday times, and different things like that. It's always been strong in that way, and we've always had good community support here. So much so, when the proposal was put together to renovate this whole building, we were able to combine with the city and the city school district, the rec center, the library, and School 33, including Florence Brown Pre-K. And I think that is a real solid accomplishment in our city and with our city school district. It shows the successful collaborations that we have had for years and years. So when you hear somebody say that we don't, you know, we're not able to collaborate well together, you need to tell them maybe they aren't looking in the right places, because we've been collaborating very well together for at least 50 years, and I can speak to that myself. Through the city, through community organizations, through the families, and that's a story that needs to be told. That's a story that people need to know about, because you don't hear about that very much. And it's been happening here for a long, long time, and it's something that we can do district-wide. We're fortunate to have a new center opening that just opened this year. I think it's signatory. The success of Florence S. Brown for these 50 years allowed us to get the oomph to open a second center. So now we have the Rochester Early Childhood Education Center down at 107 North Clinton, and we have its predecessor here at Florence S. Brown to shine the path to having a successful, long-standing program that involves all the families, that looks to ask families, what's working well? What would you like us to do better? Because our philosophy here at Florence S. Brown and district-wide has been a philosophy of continual improvement. We never get to a place where we stop. We can always get better, and that's been our focus, and I think that's what has helped our strong collaboration with families and with our community. When I look out here, I see people who have retired from this program and have come back because it means so much to them, and they have been so invested in it. I see people who have had family members go through the program, their own children, their grandchildren. This program has had many intergenerational families go through and attend the Florence S. Brown Pre-K. When I was here as the program administrator, I recall there was one long-time childcare center where Mr. Tisdale, and he would bring his children nowhere but Florence Brown. And he said he brought his own children here, and there were other centers that tried to weasel him away, but Mr. Tisdale would come to me and say, there is no other place I will take my children or the children in my care than Florence Brown. It was those kinds of recommendations, those kinds of long-standing relationships that make a program great. that make people trust in sending their children to a program and knowing that the people who are there care about what happens. And that is how we end up with young men who are successful, young women who are successful, like Charles Foster. For so many years, early childhood pre-K programs were kind of ignored. People thought, oh gee, you know, it's kind of like childcare or something, you know, they're always playing over there. Well, playing is how young children learn, and we've learned that through many years and a lot of research, and it really works. When you see children playing, they're trying on different occupations, different roles to see how they feel. It's kind of like they're practicing to be adults. And so that is what the value of play is. And that's been proven in the research. I am just so thrilled that we are able to be here today, 50 years later, and that we've had champions for this program, because it has not always been easy. There have been a lot of threats through the years of closing this program down. And thank God it never happened. And it's because of all the people that are sitting here today and all the people that came before you that this has been possible. So I would like to thank you for all your support and for recognizing how critical and how important this program has been to this community. So thank you very much. I appreciate that.
She was totally opposite than me. I was a shy person, she was an outgoing person. So I got to see how this pre-K program helped her socially, opposite of what I did, because, you know, I was kind of quiet and stuff, and so it kind of helped me to come out of my shell. But the program here gave her a controlled environment to kind of learn how to interact with other kids and control her outgoing emotions, I'll put it that way. But it did give her that base that she needed to learn how to deal with other kids. Being that she is the only child, the program did give her kids to interact with, so it wasn't just being around adults. She had to learn how to be independent and get her balance with other children. You know, how not to be mean, how to say stuff nicely and stuff. And the program gave her that. She was able to get right into that. And I also saw that it gave her the building blocks that she needed to start her learning process in kindergarten. Because I feel like now they do more stuff in kindergarten than they did previously. So it gives them that base that they need to recognize their numbers, their letters quickly, so then they can jump right into kindergarten and they already start to read, they start to do addition, subtraction, writing full sentences on their own, making stories on their own. They get homework in kindergarten every other night. So I got to see how the program helped her to be able to jump right into that and not be shy to learn new things, meet new people. And she is in the OLA program, and it helped her to not be scared to even learn a new language altogether. So this program has been really good over the past years. And I mean, my sisters went through it, I went through it, my daughter did, and my mom still works here. So it's a great program. And if we have young children, we have to recognize that they do need that base. It is not just playing. They're establishing their building blocks to learn throughout their years. You know, and it gives them that foundation that learning is important, and they don't want to push it to the side. And that's what the teachers here kind of get into the children, that learning is not a bad thing. It's not hard to do, and you shouldn't shy away from it. It just helps you get through. Even when I went to college, you know, when you go to college and you're kind of just going there by yourself, and you got to learn how to deal with people and all that stuff. And pre-K kind of gives you the fundamentals of that. You're not just used to being around your own family and stuff. You got to learn how to deal with people. Even if you're going to a store, when you're working, you have to learn that. And that the pre-K program puts them in that social setting that they need. So this was an excellent program, and I encourage all who has young children to start their kids in pre-K and not just jump them into kindergarten. They need that base. And this is a great school to start at. Because I know when I had my daughter, this was the first school I thought of putting her in when I entered her into the school program. So, thank you.
Good morning.
Good morning.
My name is Donald Starver, and I am the Deputy Director of Communications for the City of Rochester. I work for Mayor Warren, who had a prior commitment, and so she wasn't able to be here, but she sent me to make sure everyone knew that she supports this program. Mayor Warren believes that children are our future, and that education and investing in our children is the most important priority for the city. Nothing is more important than ensuring the future of our children. So I apologize that she couldn't be here, but Mayor Warren sent something special that I want to read. She said, for those of you that aren't familiar with them, the mayor, one of the powers that she has is the authority to declare proclamations, and she declared a proclamation today, and I'm going to read parts of it. I'll just read a brief excerpt. It says, from its inception, the Florence S. Brown Pre-K has achieved a level of excellence in dynamically meeting the educational, social, emotional, and physical needs of preschoolers and their families. Florence S. Brown New York State Pre-Kindergarten Center proudly celebrates its 50th anniversary in 2017 with an impressive record of achievement. The City of Rochester commends the staff, families, and community partners of the Pre-K Center for their commitment to strengthening and improving our city by ensuring young children begin their school journeys in a safe, nurturing environment. Therefore, I, Lovely Warren, Mayor of the City of Rochester, New York, do hereby proclaim Friday, May 5th, 2017 to be Florence S. Brown Pre-K Day in the City of Rochester.
Rosemary Rosetta, and it's a pleasure to be part of the celebration of the Florence S. Brown Pre-K 50th anniversary. I was fortunate to be the program administrator for 8 years here, and during that 8-year period, we designed the current logo and tagline, Playing with a Purpose, acquired a 3-year grant to recruit 3-year-olds, actively recruited students, and continued to provide many family events, including family literacy activities. Although I never knew Florence Brown, several current staff members who did work with her shared so much about her. She was a woman ahead of her time by believing that young children needed to have an early start in school to be successful. It has taken many years for this concept to come to light, but it has arrived. In Monday's news, it was reported that the New York City mayor is seeking to be a national trendsetter in providing all-day free pre-K for 3-year-olds. Apparently, he has not heard about Rochester, New York. I think Florence S. Brown would be very proud of what we have accomplished and of how far we have come with these little ones. 3- and 4-year-olds in all-day pre-K. Kindergarten teachers acknowledging and noticing the readiness of pre-K students when they arrive in kindergarten. And community and state leaders now on board with the necessity of an early start in school. This program has consistently received national recognition for its excellence in meeting the educational, social, emotional, and physical needs of preschoolers and their families. I would be very remiss today if I didn't recognize, you're all important here, 2 people that influenced me greatly. My sister is here, Nettie Moscato, who started the first early childhood school, School 57, which is still going strong today. And Denise Rainey, I see, walked in. And Denise was a former program administrator here and a retired principal at School 52, who was assigned to be my mentor when I first started, and I'm grateful to both of you. I will always treasure the time I spent with this program and working with such dedicated and amazing colleagues, parents, and children. Special thanks go out to Dr. Larry Ellison, principal of John James Audubon School 33, who always made space in the school and time in for our program and has always embraced Florence S. Brown. Thank you.
Up to the fun side. We went down to the fun side, now it's coming back up to the fun side. I'd like to welcome all of you. There are also, and I acknowledgement to goes out to Tomasa Molina for the setup in the back and the chair. And in addition to all the support connected to Tomasa, she took the lead. So thank you very, very much for your work last night and getting us to this place today as it relates to the setup. Also, I would like to take some opportunities, some names have been mentioned, to take a moment to say, I know Connie Balk is here. When I arrived here 17 or 18 years ago, Connie Balk was the program administrator, and I think you're sitting over at the, I saw your hand. Connie, thank you very, very much for coming back out. Some of the other, since I have been here, as Rosemarie Rosetta just mentioned, Denise Rainey, who started out here when I was here as an AP, moved on to be the program administrator, and then moved on to become principal. So wherever you are, Denise, thank you. You're over in that corner as well. Right. Thank you for coming back out. Some other individuals who also took the lead in the Florence Brown pre-K program as Tyra Webb Lewis. I used to call her Tyra Banks from time to time. And she was the program administrator from here. She moved down as principal. From there, she moved down to an assignment at central office, and now she's retired. In addition, you heard from one of our speakers, Dr. Hooper, who also took the lead role. Also, a lot of hard work. And Dr. Hooper, thank you very much for being here and speaking this morning. In addition to her, you heard the last speaker, Rosemarie Rosetta, and a lot of fun days with everyone. And all of you have been missed as it relates to the connection here and the work that you did. Rosemarie, thank you for giving your time today and speaking here this morning. And finally, fast forwarding from the past to the current, our current program administrator is Kathy Mikes, who will come back up to the podium shortly. With that being said, I'd like to start out by saying, I don't know how many of you have seen commercials, local commercials, and the commercials encouraging parents to sign their children up for pre-K, three-year-olds, four-year-olds. Those commercials, at least the one that continually is replaying, was filmed here in this school building. And if you look closely, you'll see a number, a room number, B104. B104 is Ms. Munir's class. It's my understanding that the students from her classroom will sing here shortly. There may be some others, because I see what's on the floor here. So I'm assuming there will be a number of pre-K students coming in here to sing, maybe all of them. But I do know she's one of the classes. And so what you see in the commercial is her classroom and Shayna Pagan. I thought I saw Shayna at some point. Shayna, you see Ms. Munir in the background walking. You see Shayna more in the foreground working with one of the pre-K students. I don't know how long ago she's here. And I'm not sure how long ago. But again, that commercial, the encouragement to families was filmed here in this school building. Just one other acknowledgement. I see Andy McGowan. I meant to add his name to the list. He's here. I know you're probably saying no, but thank you very much, Andy, for coming on. And also, everyone I see from the media here, thank you also for your time here this morning. With that being said, and as I think about Florence Brown, the word that surfaced in my brain was pioneer. And I went to the dictionary to look up the definition, and one of the definitions provided was a person who is among the first to explore a new country or area. And three words that stood out was first, and also new, and an area. And that certainly has played itself out here in our school, but beyond our school. And so we have been very fortunate in the Rochester City School District in terms of the influence that Florence Brown has left on all of us. Florence Brown can be viewed as a trailblazer. She paved the way for the pre-K classes across this district, not just here at John James Audubon School number 33, but across this district. And I wouldn't be surprised across the state, even though the mayor in New York City, I think Rosemary said, may not have known. But I wouldn't be surprised if information may have been given to him. However, the thought of sometimes people may take credit and they don't give credit sometimes where credit is due. Not that that's what he's done, but I'm always, I come from the framework of always giving credit where credit is due. In addition to the state, it wouldn't be surprised because Andy McGowan has shared, Dr. McGowan has shared information with me about national studies that are out there. And this program is mentioned a lot. We are very, very, very fortunate, and we collectively would be, certainly those of us here in this school building, but parents, relatives, and friends of our pre-K students are very, very fortunate. Most importantly would be our students. And I agree with the mayor's statement, the delivery here. Nothing is more important than cultivating the minds of our little ones. And that rule is now, it was then, and it will be as we move towards the future. We here in Rochester, specifically today, here in John James Audubon School number 33, Florence Brown Pre-K program, we are very, very fortunate. And we are fortunate as a team as we move forward with our babies. In addition to that, I'd like to thank the Florence Brown's, the staff that are here. We have, and I know there's gonna be some acknowledgments, so I won't ask them to stand, but we have eight programs here in this school building. Eight programs under our roof. Now there's been the branching out to the new pre-K site, which is fantastic. Pre-K classes are in school buildings across this district. I remember a time in my past as a principal of Clara Barton School number 2, we talked about the concept back then. And the thought, and I'll use Rosemary's statement that she has said many, many times to board members and the superintendent, we talked back then about growing our own. We didn't use that statement. Fast forwarding it to the time that Rosemary was here, that became somewhat the thought of breathing life into those words of growing our own. Back then, we talked about pre-K students coming for part of the day. And it wasn't embraced in a manner of trying to move forward, but there were people with open ears. And so fast forwarding from that point to points shortly after that, pre-K became an all-day program. And I'm thinking, it makes sense. It's logical. We want to engage our students in a formal education as soon as possible. And so we went from 4 years of age, dropped down to 3 years of age, and who knows, someday, could be 2 years of age. One of the criteria was hopefully the thought of being potty trained, so I have to add that. But you never know what the future may hold. So much is changing in our society in the short window of time. With that, the thought here is that I would like to personally thank the pre-K staff, the parents, the relatives, the friends, for embracing the work of Florence Brown in providing a form of education to our students. We have a model here across the school, and is that we will soar to do our best, and we will soar to success. And success starts with our baby scholars. Charles Vester Wims is still here. She's a testimony to the thought of the power of education. And make no mistake about it, it opens up all kinds of doors for all of us. The thought is don't miss out on the opportunity. With your guidance and your support of your children, our baby scholars, the pie in the sky, the reaching, is there for the taking. And hopefully that will be the case for every single one of our baby scholars. I just noticed my daughter walked in, and if we tried it, for me, I tried to put my actions to my words, and my daughter, and I'm going to share this, and I'll stop after this, but the thought of trying to put actions to words, she was interested in the Florence Brown pre-K program, and she did some work here with the community a while back, and if it wasn't here, it was at school number, Clarbarton school number two, and her son, and I see her husband is here as well, her son attends the Florence Brown pre-K program and in this New Year's classroom. He has talked, he's very excited that he shared the story that he will be singing today to probably a bunch of strangers, you know, but he's very excited about that opportunity. And so the thinking here, as I said, the pie in the sky is there for the taking, and hopefully, and there's no excuse why all of our children, I will repeat some of these words in our sixth grade moving up exercise in June, there's no reason why all of our children, there's no reason for them not to be in college. They should be. There's no reason for them to not to be in a successful job, contributing in a positive way in our society. So with that being said, if Florence Brown, I'll echo Rosemarie's words, if she was here today, she would be extremely, extremely proud of her work. Thank you very much.
Today, I'd just like to take a quick moment to recognize all the former staff members that have made Florence Brown Pre-K Center today what it is. For those of you that have worked with us in the past, could you please stand up? I know that you're here. Thank you so very much. Thank you.
Florence.